Paul Llewellyn was there and had his hand on the ball momentarily and might have gone.
He could have done something with it, but it wasn't a good read on the part of Sean Covey. If he would have read the defense properly, Chuck Cutler, his wide receiver on the right side, had man coverage. He was single coveraged on the right side, and Sean should have come right back to Chuck Cutler in that passing situation.
Second down and 10 at the 25. Shotgun formation. Franson and Cutler split as your wideouts, and Covey going for the home run. Both got Franson at the 35. At the 33-yard line, Franson, the junior out of Huntington Beach, beat Stanley Petrie. And Covey put a lot of steam on that football.
An outstanding read on the part of Covey that time. After missing a read on the play previous to this, he came back and he knew he didn't have anybody in center field, so he could just throw the ball out into the middle of the field. Franson did a nice job turning around Petrie, the ball right on the money, and that's how you change the complexion of momentum in a game.
First and 10 at the Horned Frog 33-yard line. Hanley again in motion. And the handoff, I think, was meant for Salido, but TCU came with two linebackers, Llewellyn and Greg Moore as well, and buried Sean Covey along with Salido.
Llewellyn timed that blitz just perfectly. He was coming in from the middle linebacker. He waited for the snap count to come, and then he came right through, and he had the running back, and he had the quarterback before they even had a chance to make the exchange. Llewellyn is an interesting player. Spent 5 seasons playing minor league baseball, and then he came back as a walk-on. Now was a co-captain, comes from a family of 9, an inspiration to the defense of TCU.
Guess it proves it's just never too late. Bellini move, no flags. Covey, now the flags are thrown. Hanley makes a catch at the 45, at the 35, and close to the first down marker, but Matt Bellini, I believe, is going to get flagged for motion before the snap of the football.
Now, Bellini can move because he's a back and he doesn't have his arm down, but the whole key is, was he set for a second after he moved? Well, the official on this side of the field, on the side that Bellini was lined up on, did not throw a penalty marker. It was the official on the other side of the field that decided he was going to throw it.
Illegal motion on the offense, second down.
Well, you talked about the Colorado State game last week, Gip, where BYU threw the Rams back. Turnabout is happening to BYU right now.
TCU knocking the Cougars back.
Second down and 23. Covey setting up the screen pass.
He's
Salido
got set up too.
Got a wall in front of him at the 30-yard line, and he rolls out of bounds at the 29. Philander Newton, the free safety, came up to put the stop on Salido, but Covey dropping back, let that TCU front line make penetration, and then he flipped the ball to Salido.
The key on a screen is for a quarterback to keep his eyes downfield until the very last moment, and then get that ball over the top, a defensive lineman to his running back, so the running back can run with it. That time Covey was able to do it. A very safe play. TCU in a zone defense, BYU coming with the screen, it's like bread and butter.
Third down and 7, Covey in that shotgun. Now he jumps up and puts his hands underneath the center. Covey looking to the near sideline. The catch is made close to the first down marker. Chuck Cutler having a busy afternoon. Down by Robert McWright, the left side cornerback.
Covey reading the blitz properly and coming out to Cutler. Cutler was double covered, but watch him as he keeps the ball away from the defenders. An outstanding shot of what it looks like as that ball comes to from a quarterback to a receiver.
Now the question is, field goal will go for the yardage. The crowd also felt that BYU didn't get a fair spot, but it looked like they did.
Although they need to get just inside the 23-yard line, and the ball plays near that mark. Timeout BYU. Lavelle Edwards wants to chat it over. 1:44 left in the second quarter. The score, BYU 18, TCU 3. 4 to go here in the second half. Craig Bowler, Jack, Jay Monson, Gift Nielsen, and Steve Lindsley at Cougar Stadium, BYU 18, TCU 3. Fourth and a foot. Franson. Mortensen, excuse me, makes the cut, turns it upfield, and he gets the first down with a couple of yards to spare. The freshman sparking the Cougars here. First and 10 at the 20-yard line at TCU.
Boy, BYU called timeout, called the entire team over to talk to Roger French and the other coaches over there, and then went for it. Usually they're a little more conservative.
They went after it that time, and a great block by Mike Salido, number 22, allowing the running back to get the first down. There's Roger French, the offensive line coach for the Cougars.
He is a competitor, indeed. 1:20 to go, first half, shotgun, Covey. And the ball knocked out of the hands of Matt Bellini, almost intercepted by TCU.
Cougars had two men down at the goal line, and I think Franson was open.
Here you can see Covey once again coming back to his back very quickly. TCU dropping back in zone coverage. That's where the backs come out and try and find a hole in the zone.
And what you call a day on the ground, TCU 44 yards, BYU 8. 1:17 to play, first half. Covey again from the shotgun. Good protection. Flips the ball and overthrows his wide receiver, Franson, at the 10-yard line.
Sean Covey is going to be absolutely sick when he sees the cover, or sees the films, I guess, whenever the team looks at it, because he had Chuck Cutler wide open in the end zone for a touchdown. It was man coverage. Cutler looked like he was running all the way to the hospital to see his wife give birth to a new baby. Michelle, I guess, is she's ready to have a baby.
Anytime now, they say.
But he was wide open.
Check a couple of scores around the country. Miami, number one in the country against Notre Dame, scoreless in the first. And Nebraska leading Oklahoma State 21-0 that game in the first quarter as well. 1:11 to play here in the first half. And on third down, Covey feels the pressure, going for the home run ball. Lofts it up to Cutler, and he makes the catch. Oh, Chuck Cutler.
You've talked about the highlight reel. That might be the play of the year.
Gifford, I'm telling you, Covey did not see Cutler. He was trying to throw over a couple of three or four big TCU linemen, and Cutler making a tremendous catch and really had to concentrate to pull it down.
Once again, man coverage, and it was a prayer, and I guess, Michelle, that one was for you. Cutler going up over the top of the defensive player and coming down with the ball. Kind of reminds you of Clay Brown in the Holiday Bowl, doesn't it?
Sure does. He slowed it down, first of all, then pulled it in.
And the point after attempt is up, and it is good. Chuck Cutler with his seventh touchdown reception of the season, and BYU scores a big touchdown here, guys, just before half.
Andre Spencer was back in perfect position in coverage for the Horned Frogs, but it was Cutler, and I guess that gives you a little bit of an advantage if you're Cutler. He's 6'3", and he was going up over Spencer, who was 6'1", and maybe just those couple of inches allowed Cutler to get that touchdown.
It's an overworked term, but Cutler in high school, at junior college, and at BYU, has always carried the term clutch as a player. He's a clutch player.
Just as long as it's not clutz, it's clutch.
TCA's.
Other scores around the Intermountain West. Air Force has taken the lead over Utah, 14-7 just before half. And Wyoming, of course, the Cowboys, Jay, have yet to lose a football game, leading New Mexico in the second quarter, 28-7.
What a record Paul Roach has. He has not lost a WAC game as a coach now in 2 years.
Colorado leads Kansas 21-6 that game in the early minutes of the third quarter. And Michigan State leads Northwestern 30-3 in the fourth quarter of play. So the Cougars jump in front now 25-3 after that Cutler touchdown from Covey. And Kaufman in to kick it away. And he got a good leg into that one. And TCU will start up at their own 20 with 1:04 to go in the second quarter. Let's check in with Steve Lindsley.
Okay, Craig, I've been over to the BYU bench. Apparently, big number 76 nose guard Tim Knight has a possible fractured right ankle, and so they pulled him out. That's why you see number 91 Mark Smith in there at the nose guard.
right, Steve. Good job. We'll keep our ear on that one.
That would really make a big difference in that defense. Not that Mark Smith is not an excellent football player, but Tim Knight has been dominating as far as that nose tackle position.
Rasko wants to throw on first down, flips it to his back. The catch is made by Tommy Palmer, but he was not the intended receiver.
TC, TCU says, you can do it, BYU, we can do it too. And watch Palmer. Palmer's an interesting story. He's coming off a big knee injury, major knee surgery. In fact, a lot of people didn't think he would ever play again, but he's back in.
First down at the 34-yard line. Rasko again wants a throw. This time he overthrows Cedric Jackson. Got that ball up high, and Jackson got twisted around.
Well, the reason that ball was thrown high that time by Rasko, big Bud Orr, coming in with his arms up, made Rasko go over the top of him, and that's a tough, tough pass when you're throwing it like that. Hopefully you can step around as a quarterback, a defensive lineman, and throw it a little bit harder than he was able to throw it.
Second and 10, Rasko steps up in the pocket and fires one down to Delaney. And good coverage there by Rodney Rice at the 47-yard line. I tell you, Rasko, when he has to, can put the zip on the football.
He did that time because BYU was coming with a blitz. It was Rasko dropping back. The linebackers are coming. You can see that inside. And Rasko stepped up in the pocket just like you're supposed to and threw that ball inside. He didn't have a whole lot on it, but it was right where it needed to be. Excellent defensive coverage downfield by Rodney Rice.
An incomplete pass stops the clock with 42 seconds to play. And here's a different look. The I formation. Delayed draw goes off to Ankrum, number 5. Picked up a couple of yards, so he's played quarterback today. Now he's back at tailback.
See, that's kind of interesting because TCU, looking like they wanted to go down and try and kick a field goal, come up with a third and 10 situation, and the TCU team decides that they want to run the draw. It kind of goes against what they were trying to accomplish on the first couple of downs. They looked like they wanted to go downfield and try and get some yardage and get in position to score again. But then they come back a third and 10 and hand it off, maybe not wanting to make some kind of a mistake.
Only 16 seconds left in the quarter. I suppose they could just let the clock run out right here.
Chris Becker is going to take his time. I don't think they're going to get this kick away. Rodney Rice back at the Cougar 20-yard line. And that's going to do it.
Especially are because Sean Covey has looked good in the first half. You believe it? 301 yards in the air.
Well, they started right off with the pass, and things worked out pretty well for him. You can see 301 yards for BYU in the passing department. TCU 107 as far as rushing. TCU at 31, so BYU at number one ranked in defense.